Right now, a local woman forced from her home by extensive damage done by an invasion of critters. Good evening, I'm Amanda Ober. The house on Quail Court in Melbourne had been ravaged by squirrels, rats, and raccoons. Tonight, as WESH 2's Travelle Island reports, the homeowner is blaming the devastation on her neighbors.
Instead of wrapping Christmas gifts, the person who lives in this home is packing up her furniture and moving what's been destroyed to the front curb. It's all because of this, a section of PVC pipe from our home that's been gnawed and chewed by rodents, causing massive flooding. On Monday night, water started running from the ceiling and down into Naomi Rivera's Melbourne home. Within a few hours, the roof literally started to fall on her head.
All the roofs kept collapsing from the front entry to the kitchen to through the dining room, through the stairway.
She called in a repairman to fix the problem.
As you always think it's just a roof leak and rude awakening, it is not. We looked and looked all over the roof. It's your pipes.
The pipes had been gnawed and chewed by rats, raccoons, and squirrels. The water built up into the ceiling and came crashing down. The place is unlivable.
I'm out of a house. I don't have a Christmas.
Rivera blames the problem on her neighbors.
So my neighbors could keep feeding all the rodents.
She says she's complained for 2 years.
They got warning by the wildlife officers, and they still add more buckets and more food.
They fed raccoons here for years, and we've never had that problem.
But the neighbors say it's not their fault.
They cut down the tree with all the squirrels' nests, so the squirrels decided to take over their home. Part of the problem is not from feeding anything.
I've been doing this for over 20 years. And I've never seen it this bad.
Wildlife trapper James Ding got a first-hand look at the damage. He believes that the destruction is, in fact, the result of the neighbors feeding the wild animals.
And people really need to know this is what happens when you feed wildlife and gets in there.
Rivera estimates she needs about $40,000 to make repairs and to replace the furniture that was destroyed. Her insurance company will only pick up a small portion of the bill.
What do you do now? Try to restore it all so they can keep doing this and next year it'll happen to me again?
It is illegal to feed wildlife, and although neighbors have been warned by wildlife officials, no further action can be taken unless someone catches them in the act. In Melbourne, Travelle Island, WESH 2 News.